The question of relating inflammation and chronic disease, I think, is becoming the forefront of medicine, as we're starting to realize that things like diabetes, cancer, heart disease, arthritis, all these diseases have an inflammatory focus. You know, 50 years ago, we took care of the infectious diseases, and now what we're seeing is this exponential rise in inflammatory diseases. So what's changed? You know, we've seen our diets have changed dramatically. Incidence of obesity has gone up. And so we're seeing this whole forefront of inflammation. The question is, can we stop it? Have we made the genetic changes, post-translational effects, epigenetic, so to speak? Is that what's driving it now? Are we making changes in the cell by our dietary changes? And we know that the diet is a major way we can affect these epigenetics. I think we have seen dramatic changes in the last 5 to 10 years, and that change has been resolution physiology. You know, for 40 years I've been a physician, we focused on preventing inflammation. We talked about arthritis. We gotta stop it before it starts. We gotta catch everything before it starts. And now we've changed that focus. We've really gone now is, let's resolve it. We have to have inflammation. Because we can block inflammation, which we learned probably went too far with monoclonal antibodies. We can block inflammation, but guess what? Wounds fall apart, we don't heal, we end up immune suppression, essentially, because we need day-to-day cellular responses, have to have some inflammation to kill bacteria, to heal wounds, etc. It's now regulation. We need that amount, and now if we know when we can turn on or off resolution, and that's the physiology that Charlie Serhan and his group in Boston has brought us. They've now branched out and shown, you know, almost daily we get new, you know, pro-resolving mediators discovered. It's taken a while to translate what information is out there to the active clinician. It'll probably take in the next 3 to 5 years, we're gonna see a barrage of methodology. I think, and once we get these to the forefront in medicine, they will be, there's no question. Resolution physiology will take over inflammatory diseases. I mean, we know that half the world's focused now. We know that, 70% of the world that has chronic diseases are no longer infectious disease, they're inflammatory disease. So I think that's where we're gonna face. Our new physiology in the next 15 years will be resolution physiology, not inhibition physiology, which is what we tried to do. Well, we used to think it was mostly genetic, and now we clearly say it's lifestyle and diet. I think the combination of lifestyle and diet is going to be what our focus should be, because we know that at least in lean body tissue preparation, lowering inflammatory focus of different organs, exercise and diet can change those dramatically. And I think that's where the focus should be, is on both diet and exercise. Well, I think probably the classic is going to be in hip replacement, knee replacement. The classic inflammatory process, which grates away at the bone, and eventually they have to have a replacement. If we could turn that clock back, what's it going to be? Get those people to exercise and lose weight, you know, with a better diet, less inflammatory diet, you know, and that would probably prevent 80% of our joint replacements. Weight loss, exercise, you know, good diet. The obesity is accelerated by our diet, not vice versa. I mean, what we eat, too many calories and probably the wrong calories, whether it's fat or carbohydrate or whatever argument we want to get into about what causes obesity, it's sedentary lifestyle and excess calories and probably the wrong kind of calories. That sets us up. And then when we follow that line of thinking, then how can we reverse that? Exactly, increase our activity, change our dietary patterns.